Hello, Deployment Insiders, and welcome to another episode here in Building 36 from the Microsoft headquarters, where each week we will bring you new tips, tricks, and best practices to make your office deployment easier. My name is Amesh Munsakani, and today we're going to be talking about the new cloud service to better manage your user policies. So let's get started. Traditionally, there were two ways to configure Office. One, the Office customization tool, better known as the OCT, and two, group policies. Both of these methods are great, but there's some limitations. The OCT did not give you a good way to modify the user preferences post-install of Office, and group policies only apply to domain-joined devices. With many organizations moving to a bring-your-own-device model and users working across multiple devices, group policy just doesn't fit the bill. Fear not. In comes the Office Cloud Policy Service. This new service gives you the option to create policies and apply them to any device your Office 365 user signs into. We first announced the Cloud Policy Service as a preview during the Microsoft Ignite 2018 conference. Now it's generally available as a full release service. So let's talk about how this works. When an Office app launches, the Click to Run service, which is native to every install of Office 365 Pro Plus, calls the Cloud Policy Service and sees if there's a user that is part of an Azure AD security group, which has policies assigned to it. The service then returns every policy and applies them directly to the device. The click-to-run service will go back and check every 90 minutes for any new policies. If the user does not belong to any Azure AD group that has policies, the device will pull the policy service every 24 hours in that case, in the event a new policy has been assigned. Now, one thing to note, the cloud policy is only available for user policies on Windows devices. Device-based policies or policies across Mac, iOS, or Android are not yet available. Let's talk about some prerequisites. Number one, the cloud policy service only works with Office 365 clients, meaning subscription clients only. This will not work with any perpetual bits such as the Office 2019, even though it's based on Click to Run. So not even older versions of Office will work there. Number two, the Cloud Policy Service only works with release 18.08 and onwards, so make sure you got the right release there. Now finally, number three, each device will need to have access to specific Cloud Policy Service endpoints. Now I'll leave a link to all of this in the description below. Now let's head to my PC so I can show you how all of this Cloud Policy Service works. Now the first thing you're gonna wanna do is head over to config.office.com. You're gonna see a couple of different options here. On the bottom, you're gonna see some options to create or modify your Office customization XML files. But in order to get the Cloud Policy Service, you're actually gonna need to sign in. Now, this means that you're gonna need an Office 365 tenant. Now, to sign into your account, you're gonna need to be part of one of the following administrative groups. They're gonna be either a security admin, a desktop analytics admin, and of course, a global administrator. Any one of those groups will totally work here. Now, once you've signed in, you're gonna wanna go into the policy configuration tab, which is available directly on the left nav, as you can see here. And from here, you're gonna see a list of policies that I've created, along with several different attributes. Now, for example, we have things called priority. Now, these priorities actually tell you which attributes are gonna be applied in order. So the lower the priority number, the higher the precedence that particular attribute will take. For example, if I had something in policy for publisher, which is a priority level 4, and I wanted to have that same attribute in base policies that had a priority of 0, that anything in the base policy would actually take a higher precedence. This is especially true for users who are gonna be part of multiple groups that have these policies associated with them. Now, to reprioritize any of these, it's actually fairly simple. I'm gonna take an example. So let's say I wanna go ahead and reprioritize the policy for Excel. I'm gonna click on reorder priority up here, and I'm gonna select that particular one. Right now, it is at a priority level 1. I'm gonna go ahead and select and say, I wanna actually make that one 0, and it's that simple. I can go ahead and click save, and that's it. So now we've gone ahead and reprioritized that. Now the next thing that you'll see here is our recommendation status. This is actually used for our new security advisor, and we're not gonna really get to cover that in this video. We'll have a future video for it, but take a look at that. It's actually now available in preview, so you can go ahead and get some great information from there. And now the final attribute that we are showing here is your overall health status. This is a health status that tells you whether or not a device is actually being able to consume these particular set of policies. So if we had a device or two that actually was not downloading these particular policies, we would show you the number of devices that are unhealthy and giving you the right set of troubleshooting steps in order to make those healthy again. Now, creating a cloud policy is actually really simple. What we're gonna do is just click on create, or we actually have the option to select an existing policy and just copy directly from that in case you have a base set of policies that you want to use and then be able to modify those from there onwards. But for this example, we're gonna go ahead and create one. I can type in a basic one. So I'm gonna say finance team base policy. I could type in the optional description. And then now I'm gonna go ahead and select the group that I wanna go and attach it to. So you're gonna see a whole numeration of groups that I wanna go, and so I'll find finance here. And then I'm going to go ahead and configure my policy. Now the policies, that you have tons and tons of different key policies or user policies that are available directly to you here. I can go ahead and filter for these. So let's say I wanna not just do office policies, maybe I just wanna do it for our Word, I can go ahead and filter directly for that. Or if I did not want to do that, I can, and I knew the exact policies that I want, I could go ahead and search directly. So I'm going to go ahead and see all policies that are focused just purely on macros. And I'm going to pick one up and say, let's see, block macros from running in office files from the internet. I click on that. I'm going to configure it for true. Click on close. And that's as that simple as that. So I'm going to go ahead and create. And I am done. Now what I'm going to show you is purely for troubleshooting, just in case you don't see the policies coming down and you can identify exactly what is going on a particular device. Now we're going to go and rummage in through the registry. So keep in mind that you shouldn't be changing the registry, just only use it for troubleshooting and support. So let's go directly in here, and what you're going to find in the HK current user software Microsoft Office 16, and I'll put a link down here so you can see exactly where I'm going. But under Cloud Policy, you're gonna see this particular GUID, and this is actually this user that is logged in. And you're gonna see a couple of different key things here. You're gonna see that we have a fetch interval, which will tell you exactly how often it's gonna go out to the policy service and download those bits and query that, when it actually did it last time. And this is the key one right here, the policy hash. Now, as you can see, it's empty for this particular device, which means I actually did not receive a policy from the service. So now I can go identify and troubleshoot whether this user that I'm logged in with is part of a particular group, does it actually have policies attached, and so on. So you can easily use this particular thing to identify what is available for that particular user. So more information is going to be available on our docs.microsoft.com. Again, links will be down below in the description, but take a look at this. Great way to identify whether or not your devices are actually receiving policies. Hope you enjoyed the new Office Cloud Policy service. To learn more, head over to our official documentation for best ways to get started. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button and notification icon to know when we release new videos. If you want to continue the discussion about this or any other Office related deployment topics, head over to the new tech community where you'll be able to chat with me and members of our engineering team and other IT admins from around the world. As always, I'll add the links in the description below. So I hope to see you there. Until next time, keep on deploying.